Hello there. Welcome to Nate's Take. Today we're going to talk about a few different ways that you can schedule your YouTube videos to go public. Let's start basic. The most basic way to schedule a YouTube upload is to put an alarm or reminder on your calendar so that on that date and time, you can just log right into YouTube and upload it right then. And if you upload it right then and you send it public, and then you wait a week, if you're doing once a week, right? An alarm goes off on your phone and you just keep a schedule. So that's the most basic way, is to wait until you're ready for it to go live that you upload it. Now, if you upload multiple at one time, make sure they don't go public when you upload them, but then you can log in later when your alarm goes off and you can change them public at that time. A very good question is, why would you want to upload a video to YouTube and not have it go public? You know, why would you want it to go private or unlisted? Well, in my case, there's a lot of work that I put into a YouTube video. Once I upload it, there's a lot that needs to be done before I want people to see it. And if I filmed many videos at the same time, then I don't want them to all go public at the same time. I want to be strategic about that. So some of the things that I focus on and put a lot of detail in is I need to make sure that the title is there, the description. I like to have a good written out description. Sometimes I have my staff do that. So if I'm uploading the video and then they're writing the description for me, you know, that doesn't happen immediately. So I don't want it to go live right then. I also create a really good thumbnail, and some thumbs take a lot longer than others to create. And then I have a whole strategy of things that I do, of teaser videos that I create or social media posts that I write that I want to have written before I make that video go public so that I can just launch it all at the same time. Okay, so now I'm going to show you so that you don't mess this part up, because you want to make sure that your default settings go to unlisted and not to public, because otherwise you'll make a mistake sometimes. Okay, so when you come in here to YouTube and you click upload, takes you to this screen. See right here how, without me changing it, it says unlisted. Okay, if it says public, that means that your default settings are public, and you do not want that. You definitely want to protect yourself and make sure that it's unlisted. Okay, so you're going to want to go to the video manager, which I've got a little shortcut here from TubeBuddy. I'll just click my videos and that takes me there. Otherwise, you go to your channel and then click on video manager. And then you come over here to channel and click on upload defaults. Okay, right here under privacy, make sure that you select unlisted. Okay, make sure that's checked. Then you just simply hit save. Now, if you know me, you know I love efficiency. I love being super productive with my time. And if I'm going to set up lighting or set up my studio in a certain way, I want to get the most out of it that I can. So I film a lot in bulk. When I meet with my clients, when I'm helping them with their YouTube channel, we'll typically film 10 videos at a time. And most common, this is for a one video per week schedule. So we just, you know, when we film in one day, we just filmed 10 weeks worth of videos. So you could imagine if you have 10 videos that you've uploaded and you've gotten them all ready, it is kind of a pain to have to worry about, you know, signing on that morning at the right time that you want it to go public. It's pretty handy to be able to actually schedule that and just have it go live. You know, what if you sleep in or something like that? You don't have to worry about that if you can schedule them. I now want to emphasize the important principle of consistency. Okay, it's so important. I don't know how to emphasize it in a more powerful way. Maybe I wave my arms or something. Consistency is so key here. Okay, now what do I mean by that? Your audience has expectations from you. Okay, they'll watch a video or a few videos of yours. They kind of get a sense for your style. And so when the future videos come out, if they subscribe to you, they're expecting to get a similar style. So that's one area that you want to be consistent, is just that style. You can change things slightly here and there. Make it true to your personality and to your style. Don't just see some other YouTuber and what they've done and think, ooh, I'm going to try that on this video. It's not about being strict on incorporating ideas, but you just want to give your audience what they expect. Okay, and it's up to you to judge what that is, but your audience just needs to feel that consistency. There's also consistency of schedule, okay? So if you post a video every week, do it on the same day. Give your subscribers something to look forward to and even form a habit of watching your videos. So if every Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. you launch a YouTube video, people will get into the habit of expecting that. Wednesday morning comes up, they'll think, there's another video coming. Also, you know, you'll broadcast that out by email and people will expect to see emails at a certain time. If you do two videos a week, then pick the days of the week that you do that. If you go longer than a week, then your consistency, I found, doesn't really need to fall on a specific day, but try and keep it specific. I mean, every couple weeks-ish is okay, I guess. I recommend at least one video per week. YouTube does have a built-in scheduling feature, but there is a but. You have to have a private video first that you can then schedule to go public. You can't do that from Unlisted for some reason. So let me show you this. Here I am logged into a real estate channel, and you see that I've got three videos here in a row that are unlisted. If I come over here to, let me hit edit, and you'll see right here it's also unlisted. There's an option for scheduled, but it is a little bit faded. I cannot click on that. So if I first change it to private and I hit save, then I can come down here and scheduled is now able to be clicked on. So if I hit schedule, it allows me to pick a date and a time and a time zone, right? And I could have that broadcast to Google Plus and to Twitter as well. So if I were to put in a date and time and then hit publish, it would publish on that specific date and time. Now this video doesn't even have a description yet. I've got my team working on some other things as well. So I'm gonna change it back to unlisted so my team can do that. That's why I don't like to use private, because then I have to worry about passwords for people to access my video and things, and I don't like that. So the third option is to use a cool tool called TubeBuddy. And there is a free version of TubeBuddy, but to use the feature I'm going to show you, you do have to pay $20 a month, and that's per YouTube account. If you have lots of YouTube accounts, they actually give you a discount down in bulk. But what I would do is I'd come up here to my TubeBuddy button, and you can click this right here, Scheduled Go Live. And the same window pops up with a calendar, time, and whatever. And even though I'm unlisted, what TubeBuddy does is it will log in on my behalf at that time and it will change it from unlisted to public for me, so I can schedule it in a roundabout way through the TubeBuddy software. So that's actually how I do it. All right, so I prefer unlisted to private for many reasons. In fact, I never use private. To me, they're the same. If somebody has the link, they can watch it, but otherwise my audience doesn't even know that video exists. They can't search for it, they can't go to view all my videos, and it won't be listed there. If there are people that I want to watch the video, maybe to preview it, or one of my staff or something like that, I can send them the link and they can watch it. Now, if a video hasn't gone public yet, it doesn't mean that the views aren't counted, because the views are. So you can have a video that's, say, unlisted for a couple of weeks, and you send it out to specific people, and those views will start to be counted up. You could potentially send it out to your entire email list or social media and get a bunch of views that way before it goes public. It just depends on your strategy, but to just know that those views are counted. Now, once you make the video public, the date that the public sees resets. So you can upload a video as unlisted, but then change it to public down the road when you're ready for it to, and that date will change. So your subscribers will not see the video until you make it public. You need to make sure though that your default settings are not set to upload videos to public, because if it goes public and then you change it back to unlisted or private, and then when hoping that you can go back to public and have that date reset, the date will not reset. It only will reset one time when you go public. So make sure default settings upload as unlisted or private. Okay, so a quick summary of the three ways that you can schedule videos to go public are: one, just put it in your calendar. And on that certain day of the week, in the certain time, say in the morning or something, You just log into YouTube and you upload it and have it go public right then. And you just schedule it to go out on that consistency, say once per week. The second way is to use YouTube's scheduling feature, but this only works if your videos are private. So you upload it to YouTube private, and then you can schedule it to go public at a specific time. So that works. Or you can use a tool like I use if you want your videos to go from unlisted to public and schedule that. You can use TubeBuddy, and again, that costs $20 per month. All right, so hopefully one of those options work for you in knowing how to schedule your YouTube videos to go live to the public. I do recommend using TubeBuddy, especially, or at least, the free version, okay? Let me show you a couple other features just as a bonus that I like to use. So let's see, right here, if I click on tags, you'll see that this specific video is ranked number one for that phrase. It's ranked number one for that phrase, number one for that. So, you know, if you type in this phrase in the YouTube search bar, you'll see it number one. It's ranked number four for that phrase, number seven for that phrase, number two, number three, and it's not ranked for either of those two. So that's one handy feature, just being able to look at my tags, see where they're ranked. I can click on this link here for tools, and you see that there's a lot of different things here. I can come up here, and there's a whole bunch of quick links and you know, bulk annotations and stuff like that. So I'll just leave it as that as a quick introduction. If you have any questions about uploading videos to YouTube that I didn't answer, make sure you put a comment below, and I will answer. Hope you have an influential day.